stuttering. Give him the rest and make him love again. In my mess of me no run again. I have the man them stuttering. I'm getting this nigga in the morning. He gon' take keeping chief and just too long away. He see me in the evening. Wanna catch all his feeling. Well, let me be the first to get my happy hour.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of FNC Real Sports Talk. I'm your boy Ricky D.
And I'm your boy Kenny Mack. And we definitely got a good show ahead of y'all today.
Hey guys, check us out. The New York Giants came to Queen City to take on the Carolina Panthers in a game that should have been competitive, but wind up being a blowout. We got the Giants that came in town and messed around and just put up 36 points on them boys. Cam Newton looked absolutely terrible in this game, did he not?
Panthers all together as a team just looked horrible. Eli picked that secondary apart like it was practice.
Absolutely. I mean, Eli looked spectacular out there. I mean, we knew this from last week when he was throwing three interceptions in the first half and then came back in the second half and threw three touchdowns. I mean, but today, I mean, this game, he was absolutely picking off the secondary at his own will. And then you have the Panthers who just fell flat. And mind you, the Giants had a depleted core of players. I mean, Bradshaw wasn't playing. Hakeem Nicks wasn't playing. You got Andre Brown that stepped up.
Yeah, the thing about it is, though, the whole organization, Panthers, got a lot of work to do. They just got a lot of work to do. The whole offense and defense was horrible. Both sides of the ball.
Absolutely. You know, and the terrible thing about this is the reactions to Cam Newton on the sidelines after he was pulled in the fourth quarter. I'm from the Queen City myself, but it was kind of depressing to see him on the sideline. You would think he would be more of a leader than what he was.
Yeah, most definitely. It's high stakes for the Panthers this year, and he's passionate for the game. The thing about it is, you can't mix being that passionate and immaturity at the same time. It's not going to work. He got a little growing to do.
He does, and unfortunately for him, his growing pains are going to have to come real, real short. I mean, he's going to have to step in as a leader right away. I mean, sitting and sulking on the sidelines, I mean, going to the bench and putting a towel over your head. I mean, come on, son. I mean, you have to do better than that. You are leading an NFL team. Only 32 elite people are able to do that, and you're one of them. You have to step up to the plate and become a leader.
Yeah, he got to learn how to lose as well as win. And right now, he don't know how to lose, and he's taking a lot of burden on his just to do everything. You know what I mean? I'm looking at fans that was just, man, they was all his fault.
Absolutely.
All right. Major League Baseball, what you got going on with the playoff race?
Oh, my gosh. The playoff race has come down to, I mean, just an American League. The National League is pretty much sold up. Their playoff teams with the Giants and Cincinnati Reds alongside the Braves and the Nationals, but the AL is absolutely up for grabs. You have the Yankees who squandered a 10-game lead over the past month and is now entertaining a 1-game lead over above the Baltimore Orioles of all people. And they've won 7 straight and so has Baltimore, but it is a complete battle going down to the line with 10 games left. Who's going to get there? We'll find out soon.
Most definitely. But we're going to the Manny Pacquiao and Mayweather fight. Are we ever going to see this fight or what's going on? Talk to me.
Yeah, I hope we do see it. I mean, it's going to be the richest fight ever in the history of any kind of sport. I mean, Manny Pacquiao laid out a couple of comments the other day on First Take that actually just sort of stung Mayweather in the head.
It's just the bottom line. Mayweather is just trying to protect his legacy. He understands that this is a fight. Pacquiao is just a fighter, and he understands it's a possibility he might lose. He has to protect his legacy because, once again, he said it to Manny Pacquiao that after boxing, he don't know where he's going. He don't know which way to turn.
Absolutely, but it's not a legacy if you haven't fought anybody. I mean, he's got one or two people he's actually fought in his lifetime, and I'm speaking of Mayweather. You know, you have Pacquiao that's going to put an emphasis on his resume if he were to beat him. And Manny Pacquiao's looking for that fight, and Mayweather seems to be ducking him.
This can be the biggest fight in boxing history right now.
Absolutely. We'll hope to see that sometime next year. We'll check it out. All right, guys, we're going to go into our week 3 predictions here. First things first, Scrub Bowl 2012. We got the Buffalo Bills against the Browns. What you look like over there?
I'm looking at the Bills going to be too much for the young boys in Cleveland. I think too much Spellers having a heck of a year, and too much Johnson, they're going to blow them out.
Actually, I think the the Cleveland Browns wind up getting a surprising victory here. I think Trent Richardson had a breakout game last week. I think Brandon Whedon is actually coming together as his own. The guy's only 30 years old. So look for the Browns to wind up winning that one on my end.
Boom. We got St. Louis Rams and the Chicago Bears. That's going to be a good game.
Yeah, after Cutler's, you know, terrible game last week with 4 interceptions, killing my fantasy league, by the way. You know, I look for him to rebound in this game, you know, against the Rams' secondary that, to be quite honest, is probably one of the weakest in the NFL.
He's no leader. I think he's going to continue his bad play from last week, and they're going to lose this game.
If his offensive line doesn't let him get sacked another 6 times from the comments that he gave to him,
no,
that
would
be game, you know.
He's a bad me. I would have beat him up. Yeah. On national TV.
On national TV. All right, guys, next game on the block, we have the Tampa Bay Buccaneers against the Dallas Cowboys. You know, this is an interesting matchup. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers look pretty good this year. I mean, okay, they're putting points up on the board. They got a good running back. Cowboys got embarrassed last week in Seattle. They're embarrassed.
Tampa Bay is for real. And they're going to show this week in the Big D, and they're going to beat the Dallas Cowboys. And it's going to be turmoil in Dallas. Watch what I tell you.
Look for it too. I hope the Buccaneers win. Unfortunately, I think the Cowboys come on top in a close game. Tony Romo gets picked off twice, and he winds up throwing 3 touchdowns. All right, we have the Lions visiting the Tennessee Titans there. That looks like a good matchup as well.
It's a good matchup. It's a good matchup. Lions, I'm going to go with the Lions on this because I'm looking at the Titans to fall 0-3. Lions going to be too much of an air attack for the secondary with the Titans, so they're not going to be able to handle it.
Yeah, I actually agree with you as well. I think that the Lions wind up picking apart the secondary of the Tennessee Titans. However, I do look for Chris Johnson to come up with a big game. 19 rushes for 21 yards is not going to cut it in this league. All right, we got the Kansas City Chiefs taking on the Jacksonville. Oh, taking on the Saints. That's exactly it. Saints and Chiefs, a team of 0-2 going in
0-3. This is up in the air for me, man, but I'm hoping. I'm actually hoping the Saints pull this one out, though. I think they can at least get up. These are two horrible teams right now, anyway.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So I'm looking at the Saints to rebound, finally get a win in the win column, and beat Kansas City because they're kind of awful too. They really don't have a run game or a pass game. Right?
I agree with you. I think the Saints wind up taking this one easily at home, and they wind up coming up on top. All right, we got the Jets taking on the Miami Dolphins.
Tebow will be star quarterback after this game. Watch what I tell you.
I agree with you. I think the Miami Dolphins wind up sneaking up on the Jets. They wind up not blowing them out, but they wind up winning convincingly. Reggie Bush has another game, good game. Tannehill winds up having a good game, yeah. And the Miami Dolphins upset the Jets at home.
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, and the whole New York fans is gonna be called Tebow. Watch what I tell you.
Set up for Tebow. All right,
San Francisco 49ers and the Minnesota Vikings. I'm looking at the San Francisco 49ers to win this defensively. I think the offense is going to take care of the ball like they've been doing, and it's going to help them get this victory. What about yourself?
I agree with you. I think San Francisco 49ers on paper and on film are by far the best team in the NFL right now. Look for them to win convincingly at the Vikings. Yeah. However, Adrian Peterson goes off for a couple of touchdowns, maybe 100 yards. I definitely see that happening.
All right. Next up, who we got? Philadelphia Eagles and the Arizona Cardinals. I'm gonna tell you this right now. It's gonna be a blow up. This is our rebound game for the two horrible offensive player turnover games that we had the previous 2 weeks. We blow Arizona Cardinals out. Kevin Cobb shows his true colors. 3 picks next week. Next Sunday.
You know, that's an interesting matchup because you got Kevin Cobb, who was traded from the Eagles to go to Arizona. He's not a starter. He was Skelton. Now Cobb's in there. I see this being a very competitive game. They upset the Patriots last week. I look forward to Cardinals to wind up winning this one.
Ooh! Woo.
All right, we got the ATL Falcons taking on the San Diego Chargers, a team of passes.
Yeah, this is the best game of the week, I believe. Best game of the week. Matt Ryan has to come to play. Phillip Rivers, I think they both are kind of the same quarterback. But I'm going to throw this up. I'll give it to the San Diego Chargers.
Yeah, I agree with you there as well. I think the Chargers will end up having a better game. They are at home. They will have Matthews back for week 3. So between that, they're going to miss Antonio Gates again. I think so, but I want them having the Chargers winning this one. All right, let's move on to one of the best defenses in the league as well. The Texans taking on the Denver Broncos and Peyton Manning.
I believe Peyton Manning going down 1-2 this week. And I believe at the end of the day, Denver fans gonna be calling for Tebow also.
They're gonna be screaming for Tebow to come back in Denver. I agree with you as well. I think the Houston Texans are too much, but like you said, a complete team, and they wind up sending the Denver Broncos back to 1-2 team. And hopefully, they rebound throughout the year, but Texans come out on top.
Boom! Pittsburgh Steelers and the Oakland Raiders. Oakland Raiders, man, that is a franchise in turmoil.
It is, absolutely. It looked like the Bad News Bears out there.
We know Big Ben gonna go through them and run through them. That's just not a game, right?
Yeah, that's not a game. You're absolutely right. Yeah. With their core of running backs, so I mean, they got like 4 or 5 running backs they give it to. But yeah, I think Roethlisberger winds up picking them apart and win easily, hands down. With high 30s, low 40s scoring against the Oakland Raiders.
Okay, blowout time,
easy. All right, guys, we have Sunday Night Football, actually the best game of the week.
Yeah.
New England Patriots going to visit the Baltimore Ravens. What a game!
And you know, there's so much talk about that playoff game last year, that AFC Championship game. So I believe the Ravens rebound, beat Tom Brady and the New England Patriots about, I say, 20-21.
Yeah, I actually agree with you as well. I think the Ravens are tough to beat at home. They're at home. Flacco will have another good game. He kind of fell off last week. Flacco has a good game, and Ray Rice has a good game, and they want to beat the New England Patriots. And then for Monday Night Football, we got the Packers visiting the surprisingly good Seattle Seahawks.
They're not that good to me. I'm looking at this game right here. I believe Green Bay offense just goes crazy this game. I mean, I don't see the rookie quarterback of the Seahawks putting up any numbers. He haven't really put up any numbers. You got to put up numbers to beat Green Bay. That's just the bottom line.
Absolutely. I agree with you there. However, the Seattle Seahawks has a great defense on paper. And I look for upset slightly, but I think Green Bay Packers might have won on that. Hey, guys, I think we're out of time.
We're out of time. Check it out, y'all. Love y'all. Check y'all back next week. It's FSC Real Sports Talk. I'm your host, Kenny McNeil.
Alongside of Brickdale Campbell, guys, make sure you guys check us out on Facebook at FNC Real Sports Talk, or make sure you follow us at
on Twitter, yeah. BAM910,
or CodeFront1906. We got plenty more coming for you guys next week. Make sure you check us out.
Later. Peace out.
Stuttering, giving the rest of me come up again. In my mess, I'll be no run again. I have the man named Stuttering. I'm getting this nigga in the morning. He gon' take keeping chief and just too long away. He see me in the evening. Wanna catch all his feelings.